Graduates from Evil Medical School have long dreamed of sharks with frickin' laser beams on their heads, but when they moved into their very first volcano fortress, were disappointed that sharks couldn't survive there. Or can they? Hey there, sharkies. Trace here for DNews. 80% of volcanic eruptions likely happen underwater. Even on the ocean floor, volcanoes produce explosions and molten lava, even though there's high pressure and it's very cold. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration reports the Pacific Flood West Mata volcano spews water that's akin to the acidity somewhere between battery and stomach acid. And yet, some shrimp were spotted living nearby. Volcanoes may be deadly, but they're considered rich environments because of ample bacteria, minerals, and of course, warmth. During a survey in 2012 of the volcanically active Kermadec Ridge by New Zealand's National Institute of Water and Atmospheric Research, scientists found rainbow-colored polychaete worms, sometimes called bristle worms. They're creeptastic. On another expedition in 2009, Oregon State University researchers explored new species around a highly active volcano near Guam. They found shrimp, crab, limpets, and barnacles. And one of them, the loihai shrimp, has tiny claws like garden shears, which allow it to graze on bacterial filaments. They also found a species of shrimp that preys on things that are killed by the noxious plumes emanating from these mouths of hot volcanic death. Obviously, when the volcano erupts, the animals all have to flee, but the benefits outweigh the costs. This is why most of the animals that live near volcanoes are kind of small. You know, crabs, shrimp, worms, coral. Evolutionarily, they can take that risk. But a large animal? That's hot. Pacific sleeper sharks are normally found in the North Pacific, from Japan to Mexico. They're generally sluggish, sleepy sharks. They are considered non-aggressive and live really deep, so they're difficult to see. But in July, a team from National Geographic was taking video of the Kavachi volcano, and they found two species of shark just hanging out inside the volcano's caldera. The researchers freaked, because Kavachi erupted 24 times in the 20th century, including twice in the last 15 years. It's considered one of the most active volcanoes in the Southwest Pacific, and yet, 12 miles from the deadly volcano, there were these sluggish sharks just hanging out. The water would be far hotter and more acidic than they could normally handle, and that raises more questions than it answers. What are these sharks doing there? If confirmed, this would be the furthest south these sharks had ever been seen, and it begs the question, how can they survive in such an extreme environment? I haven't said this in a few weeks, so bear with me now. More research is needed. More shark research? Yes, please. Sharks are jawsome. Do you have any ideas why a shark would want to live near a volcano? At this point, your guess might be as good as the scientists. Let me know down in the comments, and for more oceany goodness in a truly amazing fashion, check out this virtual reality video where pro surfer Kyle Thierman teaches us all how to read waves and pop up on your board and ride giants. VR on YouTube is so cool.
And let's take a look at the best technique for paddling out into the waves. As you can see, when I paddle, I cup my hands and I pull myself forward.
Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time on DNews.